have not decided whether this is a polynomial or not. So this is a
not polynomial.
I don't know whether it is audible to you or not. I need to check it. Today is a trial class. I will try to correct myself later on in the next class, dear students. So this is again, this is also NP means not a polynomial. So this one. Now if we come over here, the variable is y. This is your 2y plus how many terms? There are 3 terms. 1, 2 and 3. This is y to the power 1. Then here y to the power 2 and this is y to the power minus 1. Y over here, this is y to the power minus 1, which is a negative integer. Therefore, again, this algebraic expression is not a polynomial. It is not a polynomial, okay? Now, if I rub this part, say if I remove this part, then what will happen? Then we are left with 2y plus 5y square. Power of y is 1 and here power of y is 2. Both are positive integer. In that case, it will become a polynomial, okay? So, right now, let me write it as I have written it earlier. So, this is all about your polynomials. This may come as your multiple choice questions. Nowadays, we are having 20 marked objective type questions. So, we need to know all these important points about the polynomials, okay? Now, also in polynomials, if we categorize them, which we have already done in our 8th class, that is your monomials, binomials and trinomials. So, example of monomial is, say, 3x squared. This is a monomial. This is called your monomial because there is just one term. If I write 4x minus 5y, now there are two terms. So, this is said to be a binomial. If we have three terms like this, say 5x square minus 3x plus 4. This is a three terms. So, this as a whole like this three or more terms, we will call them. All these comes under your polynomial. But this is particularly a monomial because one term, two terms. So, this is a binomial. Like this, we have got different. We don't have any special name for, I mean, three terms or four terms like this. They are just recognized as a polynomial. Now, we will talk about the degree of a polynomial. These all are polynomials because power of variables are positive integers that we have discussed right now. So, if we go over to the degree of polynomial, degree of polynomial is said to be the highest power of the variable. What is the power over here? It is 2. So, degree of this monomial or degree of this polynomial is, this degree is equal to your, what is the degree? Degree equal to 2. Now, here what is the degree? X power is 1. Another variable is there, y. Again, the power is 1. So, here degree, the highest power is 1. So, degree in this one is your degree is 1. Degree is equal to 1. Then in this particular polynomial, x to the power 2, then x power is 1. Here there is no variable. This is a constant term over here. So, the maximum power is 2. So, we get degree as equal to 2. The highest power is said to be the degree. On the basis of degree, we also have some names for the polynomials. Degree 1 polynomial. Degree 1 polynomial is said to be a linear polynomial. Said to be a linear polynomial. And degree 2 polynomial. Degree 2 polynomial is said to be a quadratic polynomial. Quadratic polynomial. Then degree 3 polynomial is said to be a, degree 3 polynomial is said to be a cubic polynomial, okay. So, like this you have got linear polynomial, quadratic polynomial and degree 3 polynomial is said to be a cubic polynomial. These two are very, very important because our next chapter is going to be linear equations in two variables. Linear equations in two variables, that will be following in the next chapter. Quadratic polynomial is also very important because we will be taking about our chapter quadratic equations. So these two are very important. Remember, linear polynomial means degree is 1. Quadratic polynomial means degree is 2. Cubic polynomial like this, power is 3. No special name for more degrees, say 4, 5 like this. They are simply polynomials of degree 4, polynomials of degree 5 like this. So, this one. Now, one more thing that we come up while discussing the polynomials, which you are already familiar with, you have studied in your 8th, 9th classes, that is your coefficient. What is the coefficient of x square? Coefficient of x square is, what is there with x square? Which term is there? That is your 3. So, coefficient of x square is 3. Coefficient of x over here in this particular polynomial, it is 4. And what is the coefficient of y? That is your 5, minus 5. Don't say it is just 5. Negative sign is also to be taken along with it. So, the coefficient of y is minus 5. Coefficient of y is minus 5. So, like this, we have already talked about degree, polynomials, then I have already discussed it with you, that is the coefficients. We have talked about coefficients. The coefficients, degree, this is clear, all of you, linear, nothing new. I am just recalling whatever we have studied so far in our previous classes, that is in class 8, 9, like this. Okay. Now, if we move forward, let us take polynomials of degree 2, that is called your quadratic polynomials. Quadratic polynomials. Before I do that, let me tell you about constant polynomials and zero polynomials. Constant polynomial and zero polynomial. We will try to talk about it also. Constant polynomials and another thing is your zero polynomial. Constant polynomials and zero polynomials. What is a constant polynomial? Constant polynomial, what do you mean by constant? Say any constant number, say 2. Now the question is whether it is a polynomial or not. If I write it, most of you will say this is a number. There is no question of being a polynomial. But just imagine if I write it in this manner, you will say this is a number because you cannot see any variables over here. If I write it 2x. Now some variable is there, but it is not equal to 2. But as soon as I make it x raised to the power 0, then I can say that 2 is equal to 2x to the power 0. Because 2x raised to the power 0 is 1. So this is, I can write 2 in this manner. If you imagine this picture of the number 2, then you will call that this is a polynomial. Because variable is there. And what is the power of the variable? That is 0. So, a constant polynomial should always, any number you can take, say 7. If you take 7, this is a number. But if I want to write it in context of polynomial, I will represent it in x raised to the power 0. So, degree of this constant polynomial is 0. Constant polynomial, now I will say degree is equal to 0. Multiple choice question. These are very important multiple choice questions. Constant polynomial degree is 0. Now, zero polynomial. 0 is this integer 0. Now, 0 will remain 0 even if I represent it like x raised to the power 1. Or you can say this is 0, y raised to the power 10. These all are equal to 0. This is equal to 0. This is equal to 0. So, 0 you can write it in any manner with any variable with any power. So, we say zero polynomial degree is not defined. Degree is not defined, right? So, constant polynomial degree is 0 and 0 polynomial degree is not defined. These are the important points. You please note it down. Now we will talk about the, we will go in more detail and take up quadratic polynomials. If you have textbook with you, then you will find that in exercise 2.2, there are find the zeros of the polynomial. You will have to find out the zeros of the polynomial. So our next topic will be zeros of polynomials. Zeros of polynomials. So let us take this polynomial x square minus 2x minus 8. Okay, so before I start that, I will say that this, what is the degree of this polynomial? Degree is, what is the degree? Degree is 2. And how many terms are there? There are 3 terms. Number of terms, number of terms is equal to 3. What are the terms? The terms are, first term is x square, then the next term is minus 2x, and one more term is there, that is minus 8. Mind it, this is minus. Minus is taken into the terms. Don't leave this minus and say that 2x is one term, but minus 2x is the term. So there are 3 terms. Now if we find, going to find the zeros of the polynomial, then what we do, the middle term splitting, x square and 8. 8 is equal to 4 into 2 is 8, and 8, 4 into 2 is 8. So you have to write minus 2x. So you will write it as minus 4x plus 2x minus 8. So you see, this is x square and the middle term I have splitted it in this manner. Minus 2x. Minus 4x plus 2x gives you minus 2x. And also if we take the product, this comes out to be minus and plus is minus. 4 into 2 is 8. 8x square. So first term and the last term product is also minus 8x square. So this is 1. Now how we do that? Now from these two terms, what we take common? We take common. So I am left with x minus 4, and in these two terms we are left with 2 is taken as common, so this is x minus 4 again. So this x minus 4 is taken common, and in the next bracket we have got x plus 2. So if this polynomial is to be equal to 0, so we can say that x is equal to 4 or x equal to minus 2. So these are the zeros of this polynomial. Zeros of polynomial means if we put the value of x as 4 in this polynomial will be equal to 0. This polynomial will be equal to 0. Okay. So let us check whether it is or not. We have found the zeros of the polynomial, and we will check the zeros that we have obtained is actually giving the polynomial's value equal to 0 or not. So let me name this polynomial as px. So if we take p and the variable as 4, this comes out to be 4 squared minus 2 into 4 minus 8. So this is 16. Minus 8, minus 8. So 16 minus minus plus, we get minus 16 again. So this is 0. So fine, x equal to 4 is a 0 of this polynomial. We have verified it. Now another, let me verify whether x equal to minus 2 is a 0 of this polynomial or not. For that, again, I have named the polynomial as px. Now I am going to take the value of x as minus 2. So this is minus 2 raised to the power 2 minus of 2 into minus 2 minus 8, that is equal to 4 minus plus 4 and minus 8. So again you see this is equal to 0. So this is a 0 of the polynomial. So P minus 2, so these two are the zeros of the polynomial. So this much for today. Next class I will continue from this part. So today just let us conclude what all we have studied. That is, we have learned the zeros of the polynomial, degree of polynomial, coefficients, terms of the polynomials, what is a polynomial, all these things that we have talked about today. Please revise them, and next class we will do this topic of polynomials in some more detail. Thank you.
वीडियो है।